Hello and welcome to Python Fundamentals. In this course, we learn the underpinning Python programming skills, preparing for our journey towards mastering the Django framework and the Python programming language. This tutorial is part of a series of tutorials. You can find the link to the whole playlist in the video description. This tutorial is from our Python Programming Fundamentals for Django Developers course, which you can find and purchase on Udemy. You will find all the latest and updated tutorials, as well as resources and assessments to help accelerate your learning of the subject. The link to the course, which will always provide the best price, can be found in the video description. Having now created a new model and registered our new model to the admin site, let's go ahead now and explore the Django admin site, add some new data to our model. If you have missed any previous steps, then please go back to the previous tutorials where we go through the process building up until this point. So assuming that you have created a model and you have created a new admin user and registered the new model, let's now go over to our Django administration site. So 127.0.0.1.8000, you will need to have the server running. Quickly go through that process again. So it's manage.py run server. So once you've navigated to the admin site, that's going to be 127.0.0.1:8000/admin. Apologies. Then let's now go over and type in admin here, and password is admin. Remember, I've created my own admin user if you haven't already. And you can now see that we have the customer model registered within our admin site. So to add some data, really simple, just go into the model. And this is where potentially you're going to receive an error. And that is completely my fault. If you have been following step by step, I made a mistake earlier. Now, I want to say I made a mistake, but I purposely didn't add some code so that we can refocus on something that I did say that we refocus on later on in this section of the course. And that was the dunder string method here. So my original code, I missed out the return. Now, by missing out the return, you can see that it hasn't been checked and is not flagged up by when we start the Django server. But if I refresh, you'll probably have an error. Now, when I refresh here, you can see that it's actually blank, but you may have received an error. So what you're going to need to do here in your new app, if you've called it new app inside of models, go over to your dunder string method here and just add the word return space and then self name. Okay, so back in the admin site here, let's go through this process of adding a new customer. And let's go into the name and type in something. So let's add a new field. So what we're doing here, we're adding a new row into our database. So there are three fields that we need to fill in: name, age, and mobile number. Press save. We've now added some data to the database. Now let's just quickly refocus on this dunder string return method here. How come we can see this name, Xander? So that's where this dunder string return comes into play, because what we're doing is we're adding data to our table in these fields in one row, and then to reference this data, we're using the name. So that's what this dunder string is for. So if I change this to, for example, age, go back and refresh, we're now going to show the age of this particular record, which is 10. So if we add a new customer, let's go for new customer, age of 100. You're going to see that when I press save, that is going to happen. Now, this is a little bit of a challenge for you. If you have worked through this course step by step, maybe you can work out what we need to do next. We need to apply some of our knowledge that we learned previously into this step in order to actually overcome this problem. So if we read through this, it says exception value string or dunder string, return non-string. So it's telling us where the issue is at this dunder string. So we roughly know where in our code now where this error might be. It said returned non-string type int. So that is probably telling us now that Django is extracting this field and the data from the database It's recognizing that it's using an integer field and it's converting this age into a number. And then what we're trying to do here is we're trying to return a number. Now it just happens that the done to string here is returning a string, or it's expecting to return a string, but we're passing in an integer. So we have an error here with data types. So what we can do is we can utilize the knowledge we learned earlier, and we can cast this into a string potentially. So let's go back in here and refresh. And you can now see that we can use the number as it's now being returned as a string. So ultimately, this is providing us some useful information to help us identify the data that when we click in, we know roughly maybe what user we're trying to access, what data we're trying to access. So let's put that back now to the self.name, because the name is returning character field here. So it's likely that this is returning a string. So let's go back in here. We'll just refresh that so we can see from this list roughly what user data we're going to access by clicking on with different customers. So in this admin site, we do have a few different tools by default. We can go ahead and delete selected customers if we wanted to. So we could actually delete that from our customer base or customer table. But let's just actually see the data in the database. This can make it a little bit more real. So just make sure that you have the SQLite extension installed. Type in SQLite up here and just install the extension. Let's go back to the Explorer here. So now let's just go back into our database, or select our database, select Open Database. We can now do this because we have the SQLite extension installed. Drag this up if you need to, and you can see inside of our database all of our tables, one of them being our table we created earlier, the new app customer. And now I can right click on that table and show the data, and it will now appear. So this is the actual data, how it is actually stored in our database. You can see the data and how it correlates to what we have seen on the admin site, age, mobile, and name. You will notice the auto field here, auto incrementing every time we add new data to the database. What you might be asking yourself is, where's the number one? What happened before was I added some data and then I deleted it. Now it recognizes that as number one, so it's always going to increment to the next number, regardless if there is a one or not. And that just makes sure that every time it increments, that the number, the ID number here, will increment to always the next number. If you have been watching step by step up to this point, we now have the basic knowledge of how to create new models, considering data types, of course, creating new models, updating the changes in our database, creating new Django users, and now registering the model to the admin site so we can add data to the model. And you can see that throughout that, what underpins that process and us being able to insert certain types of data and so on is the data type that's defining this. Without data types, we wouldn't have necessarily been able to achieve what we've just done very easily. So we've seen the importance of it. If we go into the to a customer here, for example, we try to add data. We haven't tried this. I haven't shown you this. So we tried to add the incorrect type of data into a field. We will receive an error. This field is required. Please correct the error below. So we can try this as many times as we like. We will always receive an error because obviously this field is defined as an integer field. So it's only expecting a whole number.